Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to Junk Gaming Videos Mac Daddy Road to the Show series here at MLB 15 The Show on the PS4. Now, Mac Daddy and the Twins have had a slow start. They went 0-7, I believe, before they won their first game. Then they won a couple in a row. Well, they're trying to get things turned around early in the season. Mac Daddy's going to fly out to right field there. We got a 3-3 game in the third here at US Cellular. You see that Mac Daddy reaches out for that one, probably should have let it go. And then look at the crazy swing. Oh, I love that little hiccup that it'll do sometimes where he freezes and then swings way late. Makes him look kind of crazy, as a matter of fact. And here he's got an extra base hit, looking much more normal there. The White Sox having big time problems with their relay throw back into the infield, whatever. So here's Brian Dozier up with runners at first and third. The runner at third, that is Mac Daddy, and this ball is going to be chopped to second. Can they turn two? No, he drops it, and everybody's safe. Wow, okay, 4-3 Twins in the seventh inning. Runner on first. Mac Daddy would like to do some more damage. Oh, that pitch is left up, and it's crushed to right. It is, oh, it stays in the ballpark. When he first hit it, I thought maybe he'd get it out of here. Maybe he did too. One way or another, it looks like it scared the White Sox a little bit, because the next time up, they're going to go ahead and intentionally walk him. I swear, he gets more intentional walks than Jack Hammer and Joe Broadway combined. What is up with that? We've got a 4-4 game in the 12th inning. This thing doesn't want to end. Mac Daddy going deep, opposite field, and it's going to be hauled in at the wall. Holy smokes, he ran into the fence to make that catch. We need to see this again. This is a heck of a play. Melky Cabrera, he times his leap. He doesn't have very far to go. He's going to slam his shoulder right into the wall, but makes an impressive catch. We got a 5-5 game in the 14th. This thing still won't end. This is a gapper, and we'll hop off the fence. One hop. Mac Daddy wants three. The relay throw. He is out. He is out at third. Tried to be the hero there. We go to the 16th inning. They're going to walk him again. Look at this stuff. They do not want to pitch to this guy. I mean, he's got more of a reputation. I mean, he's not the all-and-out home run hitter that I picture Joe Broadway and Jack Hammer to be sometimes. But still, they're scared of him, and it's going to bite the White Sox. They play all those innings and lose this game to the Twins 7-5. Oswaldo Arcia, your player of the game. He must have done something big in the 16th inning or 17th inning, whatever it was that thing finally ended. And they got to come out and play a game the next day. How about that? You've essentially already played two in this series. That's a base hit down the line to left. And the third baseman didn't even really make an effort at it. He knew it was past him. Comes up in the third inning now, tied at one. He's got a runner in scoring position when he would like to bring home. And he might just do it right here, base hit up the middle. I think that is going to bring that runner home. And look at Mac Daddy, not going to stop. Knows that throw is coming to the plate. He just takes second base. He says, that's mine. I'll take it. Up again here in the fifth inning. Twins up 3-1. He waited on that breaking pitch nicely. Hits it deep to center field. And that's why you walk the guy, because he'll take you deep. He'll take you yard straight away center field when he needs to. And he did right there. Mac Daddy connects with a daddy dinger to center and gets to round those bases. 56 points thanks to that two-time multiplier. Yeah, Junk saw me using that with Skeeter Rabbit, and he says, give me some of that. So he dialed up a 20-game two-time multiplier for Mac Daddy. Yeah, nice swing right there. In to the bleachers in center field there. So it's 6-1 Twins now. That's not going to go nearly as far. Oh, I don't know, about 390 feet less probably. He's going to field this one at third, hit right at him. Barely had to move, but he makes that play. Good reflexes. 7-2 in the ninth. They don't even really need insurance at this point, but they could get some here as Mac Daddy's going to hit this to the left center field gap. That's going to roll to the fence. That should score at least one run. They're going to send the other guy. Yeah, here he comes. Mac Daddy knows that throw is going home, so he's going to go to third. You can't just let runners have extra bases like that. That's crazy. But yet, that's what the White Sox are doing right here. This ball's a cannon shot to left and out of here. Home run for Franson. Yeah, three-run shot. You see Miguel Sano there on base, too. Nice to see the prospects up here. I think Buxton's on this team. Sano. Yeah, too bad Buxton's on the DL in real life. Got to get that guy going and showing what he can do. But how about Franson taking this one deep? And he's all of a 250 hitter, but hey, did well right there. Twins win 12-3. Mac Daddy has a nice game. Brian Dozier is your player of the game, leading the way for the Twins. All is looking good right now. How about a spotlight on Mac Daddy?
Player spotlight. Mac Daddy is our focus. As he enters this one, having carried his team offensively last time out, he drove in a bunch of runs and really looked dialed in with runners in scoring position.
Yeah, that was one of those games he won't forget for some time to come. He was at the plate in some really important situations, and man, did he pull through. I'd say he kind of single-handedly changed the course of the game, and although that performance will be a tough one to match in this one, I know his manager and teammates are hoping he's got some more magic left in that bat.
All right, lineups and first pitch are coming up next. Stay tuned for that right here on the show.
So hold up a second. He had 5 RBI in that last game, and you mean to tell me they gave the player of the game to Brian Dozier? That's weak. Come on now. Give Daddy his due. Well, maybe he's got to go out and earn it in this one. You saw the team records coming into this. The Twins were at 6-10, but considering they were 0-7 to start the year, that's much better. They're crawling out of that hole they dug themselves. Mac Daddy's getting singles all over the yard as that one goes to center field. Then he's on again. All right. Mac Daddy getting a bit of a lead off there. Look at that. They're going to try to pick him off. He's way off. Wow. I'm surprised they gave him that much of a lead. And he steals that even with just an okay jump. He was so far off the bag. 2-1 Chicago in the fifth. These fans want to see a White Sox win. Mac Daddy's got other ideas. And wow, if you're going to drop routine fly balls like that, you might not be winning games. Well, but they are 2-1 right now in the seventh. Wow, that was some shoddy deep. Really? Another intentional walk? It's like anytime first base is open with this guy, they're going to walk him. That's crazy. Mac Daddy gets mad respect from other teams here when there's an open base. 4-2 Twins in the ninth. Insurance run time if he can maybe take one deep. Well, he can't, but he gets a solid hit to left. Believe that's a 3-hit game now. Mac Daddy dialed in. Right now with the Twins, oh sure, now they give him the player of the game. Okay. Couldn't do it when he had 5 RBI, but 3 hits is good enough, I guess, in this one. As they get the victory 4-3, the Twins starting to get hot all of a sudden. How about this? 7-10 after being 0-7. They were just 1-4 at home. Mac Daddy was getting a day off, but no longer. He's coming up to pinch hit in the ninth. Could he be a hero? The pitch. That's hit to right and hit hard. Oh, he makes that diving catch. You know, if he doesn't, that's probably a triple. It's the 11th inning now, 1-1. Mac Daddy stays in the game. That is through for a hit. Are they sending the runner? No. And Mac Daddy's caught. Oh, he'll scramble back to first base. Thought maybe they'd try to send the winning run home, but no. They'll leave it up to Franson with just one out. Of course, the Indians would like to see a double play. No. It's through to left and the game is over. The Twins win in walk-off fashion. Danny Santana scores the winning run. And the Twins get to celebrate here at Target Field. Talk about prospects. Alex Meyer is up. He did not do so well in real life, but that's another story. Last night was rough for him. But here in video game land, the prospects are doing all right. Another game against Cleveland at Target Field today. First inning, Mac Daddy waiting for a pitch, smacking it to left center field, into the gap, off the wall, playing pinball off that wall. Runner's going to come around to try to score. They're not going to get him. Mac Daddy waiting for that throw to go to the plate anyway. And again, a team just gives an extra base to Mac Daddy. Miguel Sano, here you go. Actually, he's not hitting very well, is he? Well, maybe he can do something about that here. He's going to ground out to third, but it does get the run home. 2-1 Twins now in the third inning as Mac Daddy is back up at the plate. He's going to pull this one to right for a base hit. So he's on again. I can see why they don't want to pitch to him. He's quite hot right now. Got a runner at third base in the fifth. He'd like to bring on home. This is a high fly ball. Looks like the center fielder is going to have a play on this. And he will. Yeah, that goes down as a poor at bat. But it's 4-2 Twins in the eighth. And he's going to chop this one to second base. Oh, he tried to barehand it. Why'd he do that? That is not the play you want to make right there. That's going to be an error, and deservedly so. He's at second base now. They're going to try to pick him off. Get back, Mac. Oh, it's into center field. Now he's going to take off. to third base. He's going to have a head first slide, lose that lid. He's all over the place diving around. He does get to third base. Just one out now. 1-2 count. This pitch is put in the air. Should be a tag up situation. Hi, friend. That dude's name is Friend, third base coach. That's kind of funny. All right, the throw to the plate. Yeah, that's getting cut off. Scores the run right here on the sacrifice fly. Oh, wow. Oh, he dropped it. Oh, he didn't even catch it. Off his glove, off his head, to the ground. Comedy of errors there for the Indians. The Twins win 6-3. Nice. They're getting things going. Even Ricky Nolasco's winning ball games these days. So we should have one more game in this Cleveland set. Yeah, here we go. We're at 9-10. Hey, one more win, we'd be back to 500. That's a big-time win for an 0-7 start to get it back to 10-10. That means this team's hot right now. That's a comebacker. Not going to get on there. Wearing the throwbacks today. Always love the 1960s-style throwback. They look really sharp. The Harmon Killebrew-era jerseys. Wow, they finally caught on to Mac Daddy's game right there. But hold on a second. They say he's safe. How in the world was he safe right there? They finally cut that ball and had him dead to rights at second. Instead, now he comes around to score. I would have replayed that if I were the Indians. I think he was toast and out at second base. But whatever. I don't know. Mac Daddy's going to be aggressive. They found that out. He gets a hit right here and is on yet again. We got a home run by Sano. Yes, we do. It's 5-1 Twins. Looks like they're going to get to 500 when this is all said and done. This ball hit to right field. It's got some lift. It's got some carry. It is into the overhang there, the limestone overhang in right field. By the way, Junk and I love sitting in those seats. If you can get first row in that overhang, not much of a better place outside of Champions Club right behind the plate to sit at Target Field, in our opinion. And we've tried a lot of places. So that's a right about where we would have been sitting. All this one cleared the first row for sure. It was back a ways. Yeah, almost to the back of that overhang section. But the Twins win 6-2. If you go to Target Field, go sit in those once. Those are cool. Anyway, that's going to pretty much wrap up this episode for Mac Daddy. Your player of the game for this game, Miguel Sano, as he cranks a homer in this one and has two RBIs. For Mac Daddy, he's helped lead his Twins back to a 10-10 record. It's a heck of a lot better place to be than 0-7, how they started the season. Things are looking up for the Twins and Mac Daddy now. Do come back for the next episode. We'll see you for some more Road to the Show with the bearded one, Mac Daddy. See you next time.